Hello everyone. In this lecture, I will focus on the Kirchhoff's voltage law or KVL. Okay, actually Kirchhoff's laws, two types of laws are there. One is KVL, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Another one is KCL, that is Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, and these two laws, KVL and KCLs, are very frequently used in different types of circuits. Okay, so let's start with the KVL. According to KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law, the statement can be given as the sum of all the voltages in a particular loop will be zero. Okay, let's consider a circuit like here we have considered a purely resistive circuit. Okay. Here is voltage is given, say voltage is DC voltage. Actually, for easy explanation, we have considered a resistive circuit, okay, where the resistances are R1, here it is R2, and here it is R3. Okay. And here voltage is say V. So, obviously, as resistive circuit is given there, that is why we have considered DC voltage. Okay. Now, current is also DC current, which is I. So, according to Kirchhoff's voltage law, the sum of all the voltages in a particular loop equal to 0. That means, this closed path of a circuit can be treated as loop. So, here it is loop. Okay? This closed path is loop. So, current I is flowing in these directions. Let I is moving in these directions. So, there will be a voltage drop, which is I into R1. There is another voltage drop, which is I into R2. There is another voltage drop, which is I into R3. And given source voltage is V. So, according to its, according to the Kirchhoff KVL, so sum of all the voltages in a particular loop. So, all the voltages say plus I R1, say plus I R2, then plus I R3, and then plus this voltage V. But here we will consider minus V. Why minus V? Because in that case you have to minutely follow the thing that we have to consider the current entering direction. Okay. So, if current is entering into a component, say like here is the component is battery source. So, current is entering to this battery source from the negative side, from the negative side. That is why we have to consider this voltage as negative. Okay. But if we consider the opposite direction current, at that time current will be in the entering through the positive terminal. So, at that time we will consider the positive sign. Okay. So, you have to maintain this prototype. Okay. So, it is for our general practice. That means, whenever we consider any voltage equation for a particular loop, at that time we always follow the current directions. Okay. So, otherwise you may be confused with the sign. Okay. So, to avoid such kind of sign problem, so always try to maintain this concept that whenever in a particular component, if current is entering through a positive terminal, at that time that voltage will be considered as positive. If current is entering through a negative terminal, at that time we will consider that voltage as negative. Is that clear? Okay. So now this IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3 plus of minus V equal to 0. So, it is clear sum of all the voltages in this particular loop equal to 0. Okay. So, from there we can say that V equal to R I or I can be taken as common I R1 plus R2 plus R3. Clear? So, this is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay. And Kirchhoff voltage law will be exclusively used in loop or mesh See, loop can be also treated as mesh, M-E-S-H. Okay? So, loop current method or mesh current method. Okay? It will give you only the voltage equation. It will give you, it will give you the only the voltage equation. Okay? That's why it is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay? So, if you consider another loop here, let us consider the circuit is like this. Here it is R2, here it is R3, and here another voltage source we have considered, okay? That is plus minus. So, this one is V2 and this one is now V1. So, now this is the circuit. So, at that time no current has been given, no current direction has been given, although we know current will flow from this side and current will flow from this side. But what will be the value of currents? Okay? Loop current. So, now two loops are there. This one is loop 1 and this one is loop 2. Clear? Let consider current is for this loop is I1 and current for this loop is I2. Okay? So, you can consider the opposite direction current also, but no harm. Okay? There is no harm, but minutely you have to follow the sign. Okay? Whatever the current direction, but you should always minutely follow the direction of current entering. If it is entering through negative terminal, then that particular voltage will be considered as negative. If it is entering through positive terminal, then at that time the particular voltage source will, voltage will be considered as positive. Clear? So, in that case two loops are there. So, for these two loops two voltage equations will be derived. That is for KVL, applying KVL for loop 1. Now, we are supposed to apply the KVL for loop 1. So, apply KVL. So, obviously, here will be a drop, that is I R1 plus, here the problem is there because I1 current is flowing from these directions and I2 current is also flowing these directions. That means, total current which is flowing through this R2 equal to I1 plus I2. Okay? So, what is the drop across this? That is R2 into I1 plus I2. Clear? Then this I1 is flowing through this. So, here voltage is V1. So, minus V1 equal to 0. So, if we simplify this, you can see that. So, I1 R1, first of all I1 R1 plus I1 R2 plus I2 R2 equal to V1. This is equation number 1. Okay? Similarly, apply KVL once again for this loop 2. So, now for this loop 2, what will be the equation for loop 2? Okay? So, here I2 R3 plus again R2 I1 plus I2. Minutely follow. Here we have to consider the resultant, that is I1 is also flowing there, I2 is also flowing in the same direction. That means, total current will be I1 plus I2. But if I1 is flowing, say in a particular circuit I1 is flowing in these directions, but I2 is opposite direction, at that time you have to subtract. Okay? You have to take the subtraction between I1 and I2 or I2 and I1. Is that clear? So, now here the summation, we have to consider the summation of these two as they are flowing in the same direction, then plus, then here it is minus. So, now I2 is entering through the negative terminal. That means, minus V2 equal to 0, or we can simplify as R2 I1 plus R2 I1 plus plus R2 I2 plus I2 I3 equal to V2. So it is equation number 2. So this type of equations can be derived. Okay. After that, if I want say V1, R1, R3, R2, V2, all are the known components except I1 and I2. Okay. So at that time, by solving these 1 and 2 equation, we can find out the I1 and I2, which is completely unknown to us. Okay. So in this manner, we can say that KVL can be implemented in a particular loop or in a particular circuit where currents are unknown. Okay. By applying KVL, the unknown current parameters can be derived for given voltages. Okay. That means voltages should be known to you. For given voltages, you have to find out the unknown current parameter. That is the application of KVL in a particular circuit. Is that clear? I think entire idea is clear to you. Now I will focus on KCL, that is Kirchhoff current law. Okay. So Kirchhoff current law states that the sum of all the currents in a particular node, okay, equal to 0. Clear? Because in previous case, that is for Kirchhoff's voltage law, we have seen that the sum of all the voltages in a particular loop, okay, equal to 0. But here you have to consider the node, not the loop. Clear? So what is the basic difference between loop and node? Loop means a closed path, closed circuit. Okay. Say like this one is a circuit. So, like this. So, this one is a loop, this one is another loop, but the junction point, these junction points where different branches are connected together, okay, will be treated as node. Okay. So, these all are treated as the node. Okay. So, KCL will be applied for node current method, whereas KVL is preferable for loop or mesh current method. So, KVL for loop or mesh current method and KCL is for node current method. Okay. That means, if you consider my two hands as two branches, okay. So, it is connected with my head. So, head will be treated as the node. Okay. So, according to KCL, the sum of all the nodes currents equal to 0. That means, if you consider a particular node, say it is a node. So, this current, say this I1 current is entering, another current I2 current is also entering, but so here I3 is coming out or leaving out the node. From this node it is coming out. Another current is I4, another current say it is I5. So, here it is clear this I1 and I2 are entering to this node. Whereas, I3, I4 and I5 are coming out from the node. Okay. So, according to KCL, sum of entering and outgoing, sum of all the currents equal to in a particular node equal to 0. So, we can write entering current as plus I1 plus of I2. Now, you have to consider I3 as minus sign, with the minus sign, negative current. Similarly, plus of minus I4 plus of minus I5 equal to 0. Okay? So, here entering currents will be considered as positive and outgoing currents will be considered as negative, or you can consider the just opposite one also. That means, if you are supposed to consider the outgoing currents as positive, at that time obviously you have to consider the incoming currents as negative. Is that clear? But it's my suggestion, always trying to maintain that entering current will be considered as positive and outgoing currents will be considered as negative. Later on I will give an example with a numerical example. I will show how this concept will help you to solve out some complicated problem. Okay, but if you are sometimes considering the outgoings as negative, positive, and incomings as negative, or so incoming as positive, or some outgoings are negative, then you may be confused. You may be confused with the signs. Okay, so it's my advice. Always consider the entering currents as positive and outgoing currents as negative. Okay, later on I will show with an example. Okay, so from there it is clear the sum of all the currents, although this current according to the current directions or outgoing currents, that's why we have to consider negative signs. Okay, so from there it is clear I1 plus I2 equal to I3 plus I4 plus I5. Okay, that means we can say that incoming currents, equal to outgoing currents. This is Kirchhoff's current law. Is that clear?